Hey guys, welcome back. Thanks for joining me today on The King of Random. Our experiment today is something I'm very excited to try because it's something I've wondered about for a long time. I've often wondered how different things would burn in a vacuum chamber, but it's really hard to get something ignited inside there. You can't really have a blowtorch because there's no way to turn it on and it's adding fuel, which is gonna make vapors. And you can't really light matches inside because you can't reach in while it's a vacuum. I think the solar scorcher is the perfect solution for that. The focused light from the solar scorcher will add heat inside the vacuum chamber, but no fuel or anything with mass. So it should work to light things on fire. The question is, what happens after they start burning? So the purpose of today's video is to see if we can cook marshmallows in our simulated outer space. After we're finished with the marshmallows, we'll probably try throwing a few more things in the vacuum chamber to see what happens if you burn them without any air or pressure. Of course, to be using the solar scorcher, we need sunlight, so let's head outside. We've got a vacuum chamber, we've got a solar scorcher, and now that we're outside, we've got some good sunshine. Let's see how marshmallows cook in outer space in a jar. Well, there's our marshmallow already growing. They grow up so fast. Oh, and now it's collapsing back down again. All right, this little jar pulls a vacuum pretty fast. There we go, our gauge is saying that we have about 26 inches of mercury of negative pressure in there. So now, let's see if we can cook our marshmallow through the glass. All right, I can focus it more than that, but I'm sure that would just burn the marshmallow right away. I'm trying to see if I can get kind of a nice cooked surface on it. You know what, just to make sure that it is doing something, I am gonna focus in a dot and see if the marshmallow burns. Oh, yep, it burns. Look at that smoke, it didn't like travel anywhere, it just kind of is hanging around in the same spot. Let's do that again for some more smoke. That's a neat little effect, and now it's like falling to the bottom. I kind of thought it would just instantly fill the whole container since the container has no air in it. And now the dark spots on the marshmallow are burning more than the light spots because they absorb more of the heat. Focus off of those a little bit. I think I'm getting a pretty good result if I almost focus it into a point. You know what, that's too much fun. I'm just gonna make a lot of smoke. Oh, that's so funny, the way it just like shoots up like that. Ah, it's so fun. The smoke is settling at the bottom. I guess the smoke has mass and there's nothing else for it to rise above. So it just stays at the bottom. Let's make some more. I think now I'm mostly just burning splattered marshmallow on the side of the glass. All right, let's repressurize. Ooh, smells like marshmallow. Smells like burnt marshmallow. That's the funkiest looking. Oh, that is so weird. The crystallized sugar kind of holds its shape, but the rest of the marshmallow doesn't at all. So it's just kind of collapsed around the burned portions. It's so sad looking. Almost like a weirdly large piece of popcorn. Well, time to eat it. Mmm. Tastes like burnt sugar. There you go, using sunlight to cook marshmallows in our simulated outer space. The result is that while you can cook them, it's very slow, it's very hard to do evenly, and the heat doesn't distribute through the marshmallow very well at all. So you just get kind of a shrunken raisin husk of a marshmallow with little bit of cooked parts on it. However, the solar scorcher is putting heat through the glass into the vacuum chamber. So let's try some other things in there and see how well they burn. To protect the glass of our vacuum jar, I've got a piece of styrofoam about an inch thick and some foil. I'm just gonna wrap the foil around the styrofoam and use that to put stuff on while I burn it. And the first thing I'm gonna try burning is some matches. Obviously in a vacuum, there's not gonna be any oxygen or pressure, but hopefully the match heads will still at least ignite a little bit when they're hit with the heat from the solar scorcher. I'm gonna hit this first match here, see what happens with concentrated sunlight. Not a whole lot. Smoke flew off of it, but it didn't flare up even a little bit. I thought that I thought we would see it burning a little bit more than that. Let's try this next one. See the smoke? It looks, oh, there it goes faster. So there is a fast point where it goes off. That's something. All right, one more.
There it goes.
The texture on that is pretty interesting. It doesn't look anything like a normal burned match. It's like I dipped it in glue and then stuck a bunch of sand to it or something.
Next up, let's try lighting a little bit of firework fuse. The match head's had a really hard time lighting, so I'm not sure if the fuse is gonna be able to pass its ignition down the line. Kind of hear it. Looks like it's still burning. It's burning slower than normal, but it is burning. Oh, that smoke is really thick. Oh, saw some movement down at the bottom. I think the fuse got short enough that it's burning, started propelling it around on the bottom, launch itself off. Got a nice smoke spot on our lid. Fuses make a lot of smoke, apparently. Wow. Coming right off. There's a little bit of remnants in there, but for the most part, the fuse is gone. So I think it burned slower than normal, but it did burn. Good to know. Oh, that's so thick. Look at the distance of this. Where I've wiped it off. It's a very thick smoke that builds up on the walls. The fuse smoked a lot. We're gonna try and one-up that by just lighting off some of our colored smoke powder. Normally the smoke powder has a chain reaction if you ignite just one part of it and the whole thing will get lit. I kind of don't think it's gonna work that way with this stuff.
Well, we're definitely getting smoke. That part's for sure. Let's see if it keeps itself going at all. Nope, it's gone out pretty much completely. And for whatever reason, it keeps spraying the smoke right at the glass. Makes it harder to heat up. It is kind of cool, you can see the whole focus point through the smoke though. Oh yeah, look at that. You can see that hourglass focus from the solar scorcher. Definitely starts burning, it definitely gives off smoke, it just won't burn the rest of it in a chain reaction.
I have here some of our zinc and sulfur rocket fuel, which we showed you how to make in a previous video and launch pen rockets with. I'm gonna see if I can light this with the solar scorcher in the vacuum chamber.
I like the smoke powder. It reacts, but it doesn't have the ability to have the super fast reaction that we would expect. Oh, that's zinc oxide or sulfide.
It reacted. We can't see any of it because it's covered in smoke, but it reacted. Definitely took a lot more heat. Check this out. Green smoke on the side of the container. And we have really no idea what happened. We have a slow-mo camera, we can look at that, but I think it's just gonna get obscured in slow-mo. That looks pretty gnarly. Check that out.
Zinc sulfide formed in a vacuum.
That's a much larger structure than we were getting when we just lit this off by itself. I talked about how the smoke from the fuse was fairly opaque. Look at this, like, You can't see through that at all. That is a solid block of powder. There is one more thing I want to try, and that's igniting thermite in a vacuum. Now, thermite should provide its own oxygen, and so it shouldn't matter if there is any in there already. Let's find out.
Tiny little spark. That's interesting. Oh, kind of got a reaction going. A few little beads formed and fell into the bottom of the cup. I thought it was gonna start more of it, but...
Oh, we got a chain reaction. A little one. A short, little, fairly boring for thermite reaction. Hey, it did light. That's the progress we wanted. There you have it. Simulated outer space really stops a lot of stuff from burning. It was tough to get our marshmallows to cook evenly. We could get them to burn and we got some really cool smoke patterns flying off of it. Matches didn't really want to burn very well. Fuse burned very slowly and put off a lot of smoke. Our colored smoke powder would make colored smoke, but only as long as the focal point from the Fresnel lens was really pointed right at it. Eventually, we did get our rocket fuel to light. That was kind of cool. It made some green smoke, which stained the side of our vacuum chamber, but it wasn't nearly as energetic or fast of a reaction as we normally get. And then we tried lighting Thermite, which we got some reaction out of. We got some cool sparks. We did eventually get it to react and form a little puddle of iron at the bottom of our miniature pot, but it wasn't nearly as exciting as if you just light it in a normal pressurized, oxygen-rich environment. If you ever find yourself floating around in outer space, definitely don't try and cook anything until you're back in a pressurized environment. Probably be the least of your worries. Thanks for joining us for this experiment today, and we'll see you in the next one. Talk to you then.
It's a monster marshmallow. And it's dying.
I think it's cooked.
Yeah, you can see it from the top. That works pretty well.
Hey guys, it's Grant here. I just want to pop in and say hello. You guys are wonderful. Nate and I are incredibly grateful for the way you keep supporting us. So that's pretty much it. Just wanted to give you a quick thank you. I'll see you in the next video.